BrainHQ is a brain training tool. It's part of a plan to provide a healthier lifestyle. For best results, you would combine the regular activities of the BrainHQ program with a healthy diet and an exercise program. As participants of our brain fitness class through San Diego Continuing Education, you'll learn more about how to have a brain healthy lifestyle, along with receiving a subscription to BrainHQ, which is a brain training tool. There are a total of 29 different activities in the BrainHQ program, and that's within six categories. Those categories are attention, brain speed, memory, people skills, intelligence, and navigation. Although users are free to use any combination of activities for their daily training, we recommend that beginners use a basic program with a limited number of activities. This will help build confidence in the program and promote a better understanding of how these activities work. We recommend that users participate in a limit of six activities only. These six activities are divided into three of the categories: attention, brain speed, and memory. We recommend that users perform 5 minutes on each activity per session for a total of 20 minutes a session. And we're hoping that participants will be able to put in a total of 3 hours a week and any combination, either one session a day, 6 days a week, two sessions a day, 3 days a week, or some combination thereof. When you do an activity, you begin by clicking on a category. From there, you click on an activity. And from there, you click on your desired level. After you complete the activity, you will click replay if you haven't been working for 5 minutes on the activity. If you have been working for 5 minutes, then you can go ahead and exit your 5 minute session. And then you'll click on the BrainHQ logo at the top of the screen to go back to the next level activity. Now you'll advance to the next level after 1 week, or if you've achieved 5 stars on a level. In this diagram, you can see that there's 4 stars in this box, there's only 1 star in this box, there's 2 stars in this, and there's 5 in that. After a week, you can advance even if you don't have 5 stars. So the summary of what we'll be doing with our beginner students is we'll be working from only 6 activities. They will be in 3 categories, and we will be working for 5 minutes per activity per 30-minute session. After each activity, we'll click replay until we've done that activity for at least 5 minutes. Then we'll click end. A 30-minute session will include 6 activities at 5 minutes each. We'll try to do this for 3 hours a week, and we'll try to stay on the same level for a week, or if you've earned 5 stars. Let's go through a sample of the 6 activities that we'll be doing. First, click on the category. We'll start with attention. Next, click on our first of our 6 activities. That would be target tracker. The purpose of Target Tracker is it starts with one or more bubbles. You'll see the bubbles on the screen. After a second or two, there'll be several more bubbles added. Keep your eye on the original bubbles. When they stop moving, click on the original ones. Let's give it a try. Keep your eyes on the bubbles. Keep your eyes on the bubbles. Oh, I missed it all. Missed them at once. Okay, let's try again. Keep your eyes on the bubbles. Keep your eyes on the bubbles. Oh, but anyway, you would complete that. You can see here how many more tries you have to do. You would complete it until you're done. And then you would click replay until you've been 5 minutes on this activity, and after you have, then you will click End. When you're done with the activity, click on the icon and go back to the original six categories. The next activity that we'll be doing is Double Decision. This is also an attention. Double Decision starts with one of two cars and a sign. Your job is to try to remember which of the two cars that you see and where the sign was. Let's give it a shot. Okay, so now you have to say which car was it. I think it was this car. And then you have to say where the sign was. And I have to admit I wasn't paying attention. So let's try it again. Okay, we want to identify the car and then where the arrow was, the sign was. One more time, the car, and then where it was. Now remember, I've been playing this for a while and so I'm at a higher level. When you first start, you'll have a lot more time to see where the cars are and where the signs are. And if you miss a few, then it will start slowing down for you and let you catch up. Now again, you have 27 more tries before you finish this set. When you're done with the set, if you still haven't been working for 5 minutes on this activity, then hit replay. After you've been working for 5 minutes on the activity and you're done, then you can go back to the original six categories. The next activity is a brain speed activity. You click on brain speed, and we'll be doing visual sweeps. So we'll click on the arrow. In visual sweeps, you'll see a box with two lines. The lines will rotate in or out, and you have to remember the order in which they did that. For example, they might go out, out, they might go in and out, they might go in and in, or they might go out and out. And you can use either your mouse or your keyboard to click on the arrows to say which way they went. Let's see how it looks. It looks like they went out, out. So these are the out arrows, and you click it once and then again. Let's try it again. It looked like that was in, in. So you put your cursor on in and you put your cursor on in. And that one, I'll wait for a second, see if you know what it is. I think it was out in. And again, you'll keep going until you've hit 30. And again, you'll keep doing this activity until you've worked on it for 5 minutes. And after 5 minutes, you can go back to the original six categories. The next activity is also a brain speed activity. Click on brain speed, and instead of doing visual sweeps, you're going to be doing sound sweeps. So click on that, click on a box, and in sound sweeps, you will listen to the sound, and you'll hear two sweeps, and you have to identify whether the sweeps went up and up, up and down, down and up, or down and down. Let's see if we can hear. I think that went up and down, but I'm not sure. I think that went down and up, but I'm not sure. Maybe down, down. Okay, and again, that will go until you get to zero, so you'll keep going with that. And after you get done with these, you'll look at your watch, and if you haven't spent 5 minutes on this activity, you'll do it again, you'll replay it. If you have spent 5 minutes, then you'll exit, and you'll go back to the categories. So that was sound sweeps. The next activity is also a brain speed, and it's called fine tuning. So I'll look for fine tuning. Here it is. And so with fine-tuning, the purpose is you will hear a sound and you'll see two boxes with two syllables in it, and your job is to try to say which box contains the sound. As this becomes more difficult, the sounds become less able, you become less able to distinguish between the two sounds. Let's see how this works. Okay, so we hit start.
J.
Okay, I think it was Che. Nope.
Che.
I think that was Che. Okay.
Che.
No.
Che.
I think that was Che. Okay, and again, it will go until it gets to 30, and you keep going. And again, 5 minutes on the activity. So if you haven't done 5 minutes, you will replay it until you do 5 minutes. And then when you're done, you'll click on the BrainHQ. Your final activity of the 6 activities is found in memory. And this is your to-do training. So you look for to-do training, and then you click on it. And you click on the box. And what you'll be doing is, this is a test for your working memory. You'll hear instructions of what you need, and then you'll click on the objects in the order that you need them.
First, find the bag. After that, find the hammer, and then grab the screw.
Okay, so I think the bag, the hammer, and the screw. Okay.
Get the screw, and then the plow, and after that, grab the stake.
Okay, screw. I think the plow. Plow, and then I think it was the stake. Okay, so again,
first,
you'll go to one with that, and after 5 minutes, if it hasn't been 5 minutes, you'll replay it.
Stone.
And after 5 minutes, you can exit. And when you finish with to-do, you've done your 6 activities, and it should have taken you about 30 minutes. So then what you would do is you would take a break, and you can either come back later and do another 30-minute session, or you can call it a day and the next day do another 30-minute session. What we're hoping for is 3 hours a week. So that would be 3 days of an hour a day, or 6 days of a half hour a day, or some combination. So that is how the program works, and I hope that you are able to make it through the semester and complete your training, and that you learn a little bit about brain fitness.